The Fuji 16-55 f2.8 is a APS-C standard zoom lens, costing around £900 here in the UK, or around $1,200. In this video, I want to give you my thoughts on this lens, having used it for the past 3 years or so in all kinds of different environments from indoors to outdoors, including my YouTube videos, that is. FYI, I did purchase this with my own money. With that being said, in no particular order, let's start right away with the positives. The convenient zoom range makes it perfect for traveling instead of carrying multiple prime lenses. The constant f2.8 aperture definitely helps in low light situations and makes the background look nice and blurry if you zoom into the 55 end, that is. Next is sharpness. Unless you're pixel peeping or looking into the far corners, this lens is very sharp in general. Honestly, I think it's sharper than the 18mm and has less chromatic aberration than the 35mm. If people are noticing the corners not sharp enough in the photos, I think there might be some bigger issues to contend with, to be honest. The linear focus motor is quiet, fast, accurate, works great for photos and video. Nothing to complain about here. Finally, as the name suggests, the WR stands for weather resistance. Paired with my X-T2, it was certainly nice to know that I don't have to worry about my camera getting wet when I was out and about. Moving on to things that I don't really care too much about, from my use case anyway, but it might be for some, so I'll mention it. There's no image stabilization. Personally, I don't really need it, but that's something important to you. This doesn't have it. Consider the newer X-T4 body with IBIS or the slower but much less expensive lighter 18-55 with OIS. Now on to the less favorable areas, again in no specific order. At 657 gram or about 1.4 pounds, it doesn't sound that heavy, but when I was walking around for like 10 hours with it, I really felt the weight on my shoulder bashing away at my chest. I think I've got some bruises from it. I definitely want to travel lighter in the future, whenever that might be. For my next point, I guess it's not something specific to this lens, but I have come to realize that I like to shoot mostly at 23mm for my wider shots and 35mm for close-ups, which is plenty on a APS-C camera, for my street photography, that is, in my own opinion. With video, it's slightly different, but that's another whole different story. Which means I'm not really using the zoom function as much or the wide angle it has to offer. Plus, I can benefit from having a faster, lighter lens by going with prime lenses instead. For my last nitpick, which is probably the ultimate reason why I gave this video this title, although technically the images are very sharp, but somehow I just don't love the images it produces. Something I can't quite explain, but I'll give it a try. It feels like it's lacking character. An analogy would be like comparing the R35 GTR, a super modern fast supercar, to the much older, slower AE86. Or perhaps comparing a modern DCT gearbox versus an old manual stick shift, if you can catch my drift. If we bring it back to the camera world, this inexpensive Canon FT28mm lens I bought from eBay, for example, it's literally 30 years old, cost less than 30 UK pounds, but it's so much more fun to shoot with. Even though it's manual focus only and far from perfect image-wise, it's fun, it has character, it's the lens you're watching me right now that I'm using to film this video. So that's it really, it's a practical, technically amazing lens, in my own opinion, from a non-pixel peeping standpoint. Sure, it doesn't have IS, but I don't really care for it, like I said. The images are fantastically sharp, almost equaling or beating some of the Fujifilm's own prime lenses. From a total objective standpoint, it scores highly, but subjectively, for me, I have come to realize I prefer shooting with primes, as I have mentioned, or something with more personality. So much so that I don't really mind carrying or switching lenses. That way, I can also have a lighter camera setup, I like what it can do and has done for me over the years, but it's time to say goodbye to it and put it up for sale. Lastly, I encourage you to check out other reviews or consider what your needs are before making any purchases, especially like this expensive lens. Hopefully this video was helpful in giving you some insights from my perspective. If you did, please give it a like, it would help my channel greatly. Anyway, that's my take on this lens. Thank you very much for watching as always. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.